In order to find the principal stresses using Mohr circle, we first have to identify the normal and shear stresses acting on the stress element. In this case, the sigma x value is equals to 0 and sigma y is negative 80 megapascal as it is in the compressive load, whereas our shear stress is of 60 megapascal in the positive as it is pointing upward on the right hand side. Once we have these stresses, we can draw our Mohr circle on the axis of normal and shear stresses. So to start, we can first identify the center of the circle with the point coordinates of sigma average comma 0. In this case, the average stress is negative 40 megapascal. Afterwards, we can identify a reference point and pick any one of the sides of the square. In this case, I have picked the right hand side where the shear stress is 60 megapascal and the normal stress is 0. Therefore, the point coordinates of point A will be 0, 60. Once we have these two points, we can go ahead and plot on our axis of normal and shear stresses. Now, the distance between the center point and point A is the radius of the circle, and we can calculate it using our distance formula, which is coming as 72.11 megapascal. Afterwards, we can identify our principal stresses as the extreme points on the horizontal axis. So for sigma 1, we have the center point at negative 40 plus the radius of 72 give us the value of 32.1, whereas on the other side, it gives us the value of negative 112 megapascal. Next, we can identify the orientation of the principal plane by measuring the angle from our reference plane to the principal axis, that is 2 theta p1, which can be calculated using our trigonometric analysis and coming as 28.2. Afterwards, we can sketch this on a square element. So to start, we have a horizontal axis x and 28.2 is in the counterclockwise direction, that is the principal axis. So 32.1 megapascal is acting on that direction, whereas at 90 degrees from that, we have our negative 112 megapascal that is shown on the stress element. Next, the maximum inplane shear stress can also be calculated from the circle that is the furthest point away on the vertical axis equals to the radius of the circle, that is 72.11 megapascal, whereas the orientation of this plane can be calculated from our reference plane as well, measured in the clockwise direction at angle of 2 theta s. Using the trigonometric analysis, we can calculate this angle coming as 33.69. Now we have to have this angle since we are drawing this thing on a square element, that is equals to 16.845 degrees. Now to draw it on the element, since it is in the clockwise direction, so again from the horizontal x-axis we are going in the clockwise direction of 16.8 and drawing our square perpendicular to that 16.8 degrees. Since our max is positive, that's why I acted upward on the right hand side of the square. Also, we know that the plane at which the maximum in-plane shear stress occurred, the normal stress is the average stress, in this case it is negative 40 megapascal. Pascal.